around, everybody fishing the odds here. Fishing the Selwood Bridge area on the Willamette River, and it's March 11th. We haven't really seen anything yet, but I have a friend out here in the Selwood area who's building my canopy for me, doing my my canvas. And so I just happen to have my boat stored down here. Stopped in after work, and we're gonna see if we can't find some fish. It's been a couple hours now, but I decided to do the intro now. I figure I'll make a video for you guys, maybe a little how-to or something, but hopefully we get a springer. I'm fishing red label today, not your green label herring, so let's see how red label does. Stay tuned. Get some of that, you know, not clear off my floor.
My bait's not even fucking on there anymore.
Oh, I know. Something hit it.
That was a snook on the bottom.
You ought to put a bottom on this, and if there's not already, and get like lazy Susan type thing, so you can spin it around, and, you know, or spin it back.
There's not yet.
Going forward.
Bro, look at it. That's the only snook size one. That might be a small snook.
Springer.
It is.
It's a wild, I gotta let it go, but damn, what a good day out here, huh? Beautiful fish.
Yeah, it is.
You're filming, yeah? It's too bad I gotta let it go. Get the release?
Oh, yeah.
Our next pass after catching that fish right near the Silwood Bridge. I can't say I could be any more excited than I am right now. It's March 11th. That's the earliest springer I've ever caught and landed. And, I don't know. I'm just super pumped. It's a beautiful fish. Probably in the low teens. Nice healthy hen. It's good to see those healthy fish in our system as well. And, it's a good day. So hopefully we can get another one. Alright guys, I just kind of want to go over our rig and what we did to catch that fish for some be newcomers out there. Oh. Alright, let's take a look.
Alright guys, we got here our two cuts. Silver salmon, aka your coho, or the Chinook, or your big old kings here.
You want to cut it on the Chinook side because it's what we're cut plugging for.
Today, we got Red Label that we're laying over here. Oop, not like that.
Belly toward you?
Belly definitely towards you.
Oh, and then, can't see nothing.
A little bit past the line there. You want to make your cut down here past the gill plate, a little bit past that fin. Get it all clean.
Get a nice angled cut in there.
Get rid of that.
Get rid of the head. Feed the duckies.
Going on here.
You're gonna squeeze that out. Pull the guts.
Get a little bit of guts out. Oop, like that. That's not very much, but
it's a Red Label.
Small guy.
Yep. Take your guts out.
This fin's kind of really damaged already, but we're gonna make it
aerodynamic.
A little bit angled
to help get a nice roll on there.
Over here now. Back to the front of the boat. Shit. It was hooked on that. Okay, so now that you got your fish here, you got a small side up. I like to do it up so I can easily see it. Down here as far as you can get. Hook popping out. Cover that skin right where your line's gonna protrude.
You don't wanna break the herring skin at all.
Get that down there, let it rest. And then go on the high side of that spine and come out the low side. Like, put it in there, give it a little crook, and then out that side right there.
Yep.
And this is the pro tip.
Just go through the skin right here, guys. Don't go too deep. Just like that, go through the skin. Boom, there you go.
Pin that back up.
You can pin that hook wherever you want. If your leader's a little bit longer for your mooching rig, you can pin it right down here a little bit. But the way our mooching rig is, it works like this, and that's how we had it rigged when we caught that Chinook. So keep your bait right on the bottom, guys, and there's how you rig it. Get fishing.
Second fish of the day, guys.
Neutral.
Two fish.
Yes. Yep. Not in yet.
For the camera.
There he is.
I'm staying back. Awesome. Here's the camera.
Out of the camera.
Joe, can you wash the bridge?
Cannot believe I caught two springers this early. Two springers, March 11th. And it was two wilds. What did I tell you, Cheryl?
Wild master over here.
Yeah, no kidding. Well, that's another nice one, isn't it?
A little smaller, but yeah.
Good work on the wheel, by the way.
Couldn't do anything.
All right, guys.
Awesome.
There it
second
is.
Second wild.
Yeah, I think that is a little smaller.
March 11th. This one's smaller, but still a beautiful fish. That's bad luck on the wilds. All right, guys. Let's give this one a release. Wow, I can't believe I just got two wilds.
Especially, that's kind of nice to see that there's two
wilds.
Let's
get this guy back in the water. All right.
right, guys. Unreal. Never have I hooked two springers in one day and landed them. I've gotten two takedowns in one day last year. I landed one and the other one short striked it, but I'm so pumped right now. Everybody in the boat's pumped. Two springers. They're both wild, unfortunately. That's just luck of the draw, I guess. But it's March 11th, and like I said, I couldn't be more pumped. So we're gonna try to get a couple more fish here, and both those fish came real close to each other, probably 30, 40 yards apart in the troll. So that's pretty awesome. Both of them were right in the 20-foot range, 20 foot, 23, 24, 5 feet. So there you go. We showed you guys a nice spin on your herring, and stay tuned. Let's get another fish, huh? Three for the day. This early, can't beat it.
How'd you do today, dude?
Well, I mean, I had one of the best days of springer fishing I ever had in my life. Just for the fact that I came out after work, and you know, we didn't fish a whole lot, but we caught some nice springers. And I got my boat sitting right here in the sailboat area. It's just out of dock, and I just came down after work and hopped in. You know, long story short, we got a couple springers in the boat, and both of them came on a herring and fishing bottom. They're about 40 yards apart. Probably about, what do you say, an hour apart?
Yeah, I'd say an hour apart.
Give or take. Got my buddy Kelly right there behind the camera. And we just had a killer day out here. I couldn't ask for a better day. And, you know, I did all this work to my boat. I got it ready for springer fishing. And this is a hell of a way to kick off the year. You know, it's a great start with the new boat and everything. I got the vinyl floors, new chairs, steering, the whole nine. I got this canopy that's about to get done. And I'm just pretty happy with the year so far. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Enjoyed the cool content. Stay tuned for the next one. Gonna fill up the boat with gas next time. Got the portable gas can. Taking it on the docks. It's gonna be a good springer here, guys.